is Annette and Victor Fuentes. Big round of applause. Just to let you know, these people are the salt of the earth. I love them dearly.
I just want to say thank you, everybody, for coming and supporting us. And what a great bunch of people. And you know what? We're going to win this fight. For sure, we're going to win this fight.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. I just want to say, Ken Gary is here, and his wife used to be the secretary for this ranch, and he brought us the sign. It's really a great sign, but it's also sad because this is the sign that they used. You want to hold that up so they can see it? It's the sign that they used when they had to auction off and shut down the ranch. And this is, Ken, this was from when, the 60s, 70s? 73. That's history right there. You know, and it's very sad over the Devil's Hole pupfish. And they were able, I talked to Mr. Caparet's daughter-in-law, and she was telling me they were able to reproduce the Devil's Hole pupfish. So that's our government. But thank you all for coming, and everybody that's worked hard, we thank you all. You know, we got a great bunch of friends.
Thanks everybody for coming today. But one of the things that I want to say is that somebody told me that in the quarter of 95 and 373, they have some police over there and some ranger. You know, I don't know who they're watching. You know, I want to say this. As far as I know, the criminals are in $10 million building. Sitting right there. We haven't stolen anything. We haven't diverted no water. We haven't break any law. The lawbreakers are over there. Yeah. And they're watching us. Something is wrong right here. Yeah. They're watching us. See? Mm-hmm. So something needs to be changed in America. Something needs to be changed in Nike County.
Change back to the law.
Yeah. Fish and Wildlife, BLM, and Forestry, they need to get out from our state. We don't need them. Yes. Farmer that they destroyed, he produced for us. He provided a paycheck for people. Fish and Wildlife, Forestry, and BLM, they are wasting our money. We are working for them. We are paying them for them to destroy us. Think about it. Think about it. They don't produce no potatoes. I know you know potatoes that and the box say, you know, Fish and Wildlife produce this. Or real there. Something is wrong in America, and we are eating it. I want to tell you something. Look around in this building and look the age of the people in this building. I don't want to offend anybody. But this is the last generation fighting for freedom in America.
Yeah. Amen.
Generation has been indoctrinated to be communist, yeah. Yeah. Socialist.
Yes.
I'm giving you a free phone. See? I'm giving you free education.
For
believe me, believe me what I told you. Believe me, my friend, I come from Cuba. I lived 26 years of my life in Cuba. Nobody told me this. I lived there. I didn't read it in a textbook. I lived there. And other half here, I'm 52. I know that system, and I don't. And I know, and what this system has become into, because it's not as it used to be. Yeah. See, where they control what you eat, what you wear, where you live, where you drive. They control everything. They control your life, and you have no freedom to speak. If you say something against the government, you gotta go in. They mark you. They don't have a computer in Cuba. Listen to this. They don't have a computer like they have here. And for some reason, when you are against the government in Cuba, you're going to apply for a work, and they know that you are against the government. You go to the next office, they know you. I don't know how they do it. Without computer, and here they have computer, and they check your social security. But over there, I don't know how they do it. That is how controlled that society is. And that is and what this is becoming to. Believe me, my friend, don't let anybody to lie to you. Let's fight for freedom. Let's fight for what is true. I want to thank our new attorney, Chris, from Christian, from Marcus Clay Legal Foundation. They're going to start to work on our case. But we have to go beyond that. We have to wake up. We need to fight. We need to believe again. We need to pray again. They also want to take our prayer. I didn't know anything about God when I was in Cuba. Nothing. I wasn't able to own a Bible. And I was telling my friend a long time ago, you know, when I read the book of Genesis, I find out that I was free. Mm-hmm. I was created free. I don't belong to any government. I was free. When I read the Bible, and then I understand something. My dad used to own a gun. I remember growing up, but I remember that gun. Yeah. And the government in Cuba, the first thing that they did, they took the Bible. You don't need to believe in God. We are your God. We are your provider. So see, they steal your faith. That is the first thing the eight communist government do. What is happening in America, my friend? You mention the name of Jesus, it's like you throw poison or something. This is not new. Second thing that they did, they took the gun from the hand of the people. Guess what? After that, they control everything. You raise one hand and they chop you up. See? So we need to be careful, my friend. We need to fight. We have to wake up. We need to recognize that we are under attack by our own government. That is the truth. These guys over here, my friend, the Bounties, they have a ranch. And they use BLM land, you know, for their cattle and stuff. We have a private land. We have no cattle. We are no rancher. We are no spraying water in the air. And they took our water and they took our property. So it's about cow. It's not about cow. Believe me what I tell you. It's about the usurpation of your property and your right and your freedom. It's about Amen. Control. Amen. My friend, Amen. Think about that. Now, we have our sheriff. And we have our elected officials. They are supposed to defend us. They are supposed to protect us. But you know what happened? They are sold out to the Fed. Yeah. I go to the commissioner meeting, and it breaks my heart when the federal government gave Nine County $1 million. It seemed like a lot. And they just said, you know, $1 million. And somebody said, oh, that is good. They gave us $1 million. How much they take from us?
Yeah.
Think about it. I come from Cuba. I don't understand too much about it, but you know, I try to make sense over here. How much they take from us? And then they give us $1 million, and everybody says, hey.
Pennies.
And I look, and it set me. Break my heart. But you know, I think in the end, we're going to win. We will win. But remember, keep your Bible and your gun. Don't allow anybody to take your hand.